Hi. So today I'm planning to install Docker on an Amazon AMI. I have already launched my Amazon instance, which is currently running. So I have opened in that particular terminal. You can see that the terminal session of particular instance. So let me check whether the Docker is available or not. So if you look at the Docker hyphen it will provide the version information. Currently there should not be any Docker available, so I have to install it. So let me install a Docker on the instance. Sudo yum install docker minus y. So installation process is started. So this installation basically install Docker on my instance. So the Docker is installed. So we can look the Docker version. Docker hyphen minus v. Pardon. Sudo Docker hyphen v. So you can get the brief information about the Docker version, the current version. So if you are looking for, if you want to see more about the version, you can use Docker hyphen version. So version is not, hyphen is not required. So you can get something more information about the Docker. So which means currently our Docker is installed. So we need to verify the Docker is running or not. So we proceed. Sudo service docker status. So currently Docker is inactive, so which means Docker is not running. Let me start the Docker. So instead of status, I give it start. Again, I will check for the status. So you can see that the Docker is running. So let me clear the screen. Now we are installed the Docker on the instance and which is running. So let me tell you about something about the architecture. You can see this is actually the architecture of the Docker. The Docker basically consists of a Docker client, Docker host and registry. So registry is a public repo where the Docker image is available. So whenever the Docker host needed any images, if it is not available on the Docker host, it will pull the images from the Docker registry. The Docker client which will used for interacting with the Docker host. Currently we are using our terminal as Docker client. So our Docker host is our instance where we installed our Docker. So Docker consists of a Docker daemon, so which manages the container images section in the Docker. So we'll go back to the terminal. Currently nothing available because it's newly installed. Let me check for the images. You can see that there is nothing available on the images because we don't have installed anything. So let me pull an image from the Docker registry. Sudo docker pull ubuntu. So now I am pulling an Ubuntu image. So which you can see the Ubuntu image is pulled from the Docker. Let me check the images. So you can see that the Ubuntu is available now with our image repository, local image repository. So we'll look for Docker container availability. So Docker PS command is basically used for to view the running instance, Docker instance. Currently nothing available. If you provide a Docker hyphen A command, which will show all the instances with stopped, start, and running, including stopped and running images. So currently nothing available. So we have already an image in our local repo, local image repo. So let me launch a container from there with the help of that image. So sudo docker run. So run command will start to run container, which will build it. Not build, it will create a container with the help of a particular images. So it is hyphen it given for open the interactive terminal for the container. So once you launch, you will be enter inside the container. So hyphen name, I'm giving my Ubuntu, and the image name is Ubuntu. So you can give furthermore information like port name, tag, but currently I am using this much. So this is enough to launch a container. So which means it's created, there should not be any error. You can see that we are logged inside the Docker. You can see the name, a root with the particular name of or whatever it should be. So you, one thing you can see, it's very fast. You can immediately create your own container from a particular image. So now I am inside the container. Let me see the ls command. I'm going inside home directory and just create a file. Touch nickel.txt. Let me ls. So you can see nickel.txt created. So how do we come out from this? So just press Ctrl P and Ctrl Q. So you will come out from the system. Now you can see you are reaches to the Docker host. So let me clear first and we'll check for the Docker PS command. Sudo Docker PS. So now you can see that your Ubuntu with the name my Ubuntu is running, which is up and run, and you can check that sudo docker images, your image information also. So you have a running container and you have a local Ubuntu image also. So now what I'm going to do, I will, so now you came out from the Docker. How do we can again go inside the container with just a attach command, sudo docker attach. So the id of the container, so we are inside the Docker, just ls. So you can see that the file one which I created. So again I am coming out from the Docker container. So Ctrl P, Ctrl Q. So you came out from the container. Clear. Now I will stop the Docker running instant. Sudo docker. First we check the PS command. We need the ID. Now sudo docker stop the ID. This is very fast. You can now check PS command. You will not get the information because the Docker is stopped. You need to provide docker -a. So now you can see your Docker is stopped. So what I am going to do, I am just removing the Docker. Sudo docker rm and the ID. If we again check documents, you can see the container is removed. So now I will remove Docker images. So I don't have permission without sudo. Sudo. Now I will remove the image. Docker. Again, forget the sudo command. Sudo docker. So here remove is rmi. Rmi means remove image. There for remove container you need to use just rm. So I'll give the image id. So it's removed. You can check your images. It's empty now. Let me clear it out. So now I will remove my Docker, install Docker itself from the system. So yum remove Docker. Right. I miss sudo. Sudo. So if you check Docker version, sudo Docker version, you can see nothing available now. So I install the Docker, then I pull an image, run a container, stop the container, attach inside the container, remove the container and remove the image. Finally I remove the Docker. So this is a little workaround in the Docker which is running on an Amazon AMI. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe my videos.